everybody. This is Ben McCone with Tornado Warned. This is a documentary from the chasing event of Hurricane Ida, and this includes all of my footage, with the exception of my probe footage, which can also be seen on my channel. On August 29th, 2021, which was the 16th anniversary of Hurricane Katrina making landfall, Hurricane Ida made landfall near Port Fourchon, Louisiana, as a Category 4, with sustained winds of 150 miles an hour. Hurricane Ida caused at least $75.25 billion U.S. dollars in damages and killed 107 people, 87 in the U.S. and 20 in Venezuela. I do hope you enjoy this documentary, and I'll catch you on the next one.
All right, well, we are officially on our way to Louisiana right now. It's like 1:15 in the morning, Saturday, August 28th. And just left Savannah, Georgia, probably 30 minutes ago. So we have another 10 or so hours to go until we're in Louisiana. Probably gonna stop. Just getting into Mississippi tonight, sleep for a couple hours, then get down there and start scouting out some spots to go and intercept as what will soon be Major Hurricane Ida. As that system moves in, expecting landfall somewhere around Sunday afternoon, evening, nighttime, somewhere around there. So we'll have all day tomorrow to make sure that everything's in order and we're in the right position. It gets harder to travel on the day of a landfall. Just there's roadblocks everywhere and it just turns into a big hassle. So we try to get there early and scout it out and get some footage of people evacuating and setting up, preparing. That's the current plan. City. That's where we're going to meet up with everybody and hang out for the night. Kind of go over models, see what's going on, and see if we have to move anywhere else. Around Morgan City is where we're thinking right now. the track looks like it's shifting a little bit further east than anticipated, so we might even end up in New Orleans. Hopefully not. I know that city's been through a lot, especially, you know, with Katrina specifically. But we'll have to see how it goes. Hopefully we don't end up there, and you know, maybe it can weaken down a little bit. Still supposed to be at 130 miles an hour at landfall, which is Cat 4. So they're worried about dry air getting entrained up into the circulation. We'll have to see if that doesn't happen. I could foresee it going higher than a Cat 4, or at least higher than 130 mile an hour sustained winds. But everything's up in the air right now. This is a fast moving system. We're just gonna have to kind of see how it plays out over the next 12 hours or so. 18 hours maybe max is when our last chance to move would likely be. Wouldn't want to be caught driving through the outer eyewall in this, especially not the inner eyewall. I don't mind being in a vehicle during it, but I wouldn't want to be traveling to a different destination at the time. Don't want to get caught in between, especially with storm surge in these low-lying areas of the bayous in Louisiana. So we're just gonna have to wait and see.
What do you guys think of a strengthening Cat 4 heading towards us out here in the middle of nowhere? Yeah? That's hate?
Yeah. We don't have much to say.
Yeah. Well, just wanted to get one final video in while we're all in one piece. Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of sitting right here, but something's gonna rip off of a roof somewhere. I can hear it banging around.
literally just thinking, I'm looking everywhere and there's nowhere I can see that doesn't have power lines. Thank you. Yeah, their following is a little bit bigger than this page. Best choice. Thank you. bad. What? I'm trying to go. you doing, buddy? Thank you. God. Shit! that.
Same.
So yeah, sailboat's dead, we lost our stream.
Same.
We had the most successful stream in PSE.
Yeah. It's getting
pretty good.
Thank you.
are we doing stopping right here?
Not only did this storm produce high winds, significant rainfall in the Louisiana area, but as it moved on shore, it rapidly weakened into a tropical storm, then depression, and then post-tropical cyclone as it moved over the northeastern states. As it did that, it produced catastrophic flash flooding and tornadoes. A total of 30 deaths were in Louisiana, 29 were in New Jersey, 17 in New York, 5 in Pennsylvania, 2 in Mississippi, 2 in Alabama, 1 in Maryland, and 1 in Connecticut. A significant amount of deaths in Louisiana and the greater New Orleans area were a result of carbon monoxide poisoning while using portable gas generators with inadequate ventilation. If you're not already subscribed, please consider it, especially if you enjoy watching this video, and feel free to check out my other videos, as I do specialize in long format chasing videos that are typically greater than 15 to 20 minutes.